The 1st of January is the anniversary of Australia's Federation, our Federation Day, the day Australia was established as a nation. On 1st of January in 1901, a British Act was declared making Australia a federation of states, called the Commonwealth of Australia, and establishing its constitution and form of government. On that day, Australia's first head, its Governor-General, Lord Hopetoun, was sworn in, as was its first Prime Minister, Edmund Barton, and Australia's first Federal Cabinet. On that day in 1901, a procession of dignitaries, bands, soldiers and horse-drawn floats passed through Sydney city centre and marched 5.5 miles to Centennial Park. The streets and balconies were lined with thousands of spectators. Buildings were elaborately decorated with banners celebrating the event. The slogan of the Federation was, "One People, One Destiny." Special arches were set up for the procession and the occasion. There was an arch provided by France and an arch provided by the United States of America. The Australian wool growers set up an arch. There was a coal industry arch. There was the permanent Commonwealth Arch in Bridge Street. The procession also went past the Queen's statue. In the packed Centennial Park, Lord Hopetoun, the Governor-General-elect, the Primate of Sydney's Church of England, Archbishop William Smith, the new Prime Minister Edmund Barton, and other dignitaries gathered in the specially constructed pavilion. The choir of St Andrew's Church sang the hymn, "O God, our help in ages past." The crowd stood with bared heads. With deep intonation, Archbishop Smith then read the prayers for the Commonwealth. O Lord God Almighty, high above all height, whose lifetime is eternity, we, thine unworthy servants, give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness. We glorify thee in that thou hast been pleased in thy providence to unite Australia in the bonds of brotherly love and accord, and in one Commonwealth, under our most gracious Sovereign Lady, Queen Victoria. We beseech thee, grant unto this union thy grace and heavenly benediction, that a strong people may arise to hallow thy name, to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly before thee in reverence and righteousness of life. Furthermore, we pray thee to make our empire always a faithful and fearless leader among the nations in all that is good, and to bless our Queen and those who are put in authority under her, more especially in this land. Let thy wisdom be their guide, strengthen them in uprightness, direct and rule their hearts, that they may govern according to thy holy will, and vouchsafe that all things may be so ordered and settled upon the best and surest foundations, that peace and happiness, truth and justice, religion and piety may be deepened and increased among us, and that we, thy people, may perpetually praise and magnify thee from generation to generation. Blessed be thy name for ever and ever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Then followed the prayer for the Governor-General and the Lord's Prayer. The supreme moment had arrived. Guns boomed forth a salute, proclaiming to the world, as Lord Hopetoun signed his name, that he had assumed his official duties and was invested with all the powers conferred by the new constitution. A new nation had been born. Te Deum Laudamus, a hymn of Christian praise and affirmation of God and Christ, was then sung. After swearing in of the Prime Minister and Australia's first Federal Cabinet, the ceremonies then came to an end. Celebrations went on in Sydney for 2 weeks, and there were celebrations in all states. On 9th of May that year, 1901, the first Federal Parliament was opened in Melbourne. So we celebrate on Songs of Hope Australia's Day of Federation, 1st of January. On this day, in 1901, our nation was born, and God's blessing was sought.